Welcome to the bookstore. Have you been here before? No? Okay, well, we're a used bookstore. We believe that books should be kept under pretty much any circumstances, so we accept books at any quality, even if pages are falling out or they're not really in the greatest shape. We still like to keep them. And so our prices are often really low, and so we're a really nice place to shop. Yeah. Oh, you called? Right, I remember. You want to buy some gifts for your cousins, is that right? Oh, okay, so you're going to visit your little cousins? Okay, you want to bring them some books as a gift. Well, that's great. I know people usually think about toys when they want to give a gift, but books can be really, really special, especially for kids. They can read them for a long time or at a lot of ages, and it can be nice even as an adult to revisit books that you liked as a kid. So I think that's great. So how old did you say they were? 7? Okay, and 5. Okay, 7 and 5. Those are really good ages for picture books. They're both in picture book age, which is convenient, so they can do a lot of sharing. The 5-year-old will be reading probably not at all independently, maybe a tiny bit. The 7-year-old might be doing a mix of independent reading and story times or having an adult read to them. Does that sound about right? Yeah. Okay. Well, great. Firstly, I pulled a stack of books for you. I forgot to say. When you called, I got really excited and I pulled several books that I thought might be a good fit. The first one I'm a little bit less sure about. This would only be appropriate for the 7-year-old. I probably would say not so much for the 5-year-old. But this book is really popular right now, and that's because they just adapted it into a movie, and scary stories to tell in the dark. Little kids really like this book. They like to look at the pictures. By little kids, I mean elementary school. The 5-year-old might like to look at the pictures, but probably their mom's not going to want them necessarily to do so. So the pictures are really they can be a little spooky. Some of the pictures are very spooky. Let me find one for you so you can get a sense. Like, here you go, here's an example. Pretty spooky. Yeah. So the 7-year-old would probably find this more appropriate, but yeah, you think that their mom might say, not so much. That's understandable. You don't want your kids having nightmares or being afraid. And this book has been around for a really, really long time. Let's see. Yeah, since 1981, so it's a long time. It was around when I was a kid, and a while ago, and I used to cover up the pictures with my hand so I could read the stories because I thought it was too scary. So I understand. So we'll just put that. We'll just put this aside. Okay, my other ones are a little bit less mature, a little less out there. So I'm a little more confident in them. Okay. So my next recommendation is this picture book, 10 in the Bed. And I know 10 in the Bed is sort of a common children's rhyme, so you might think, like, why would you need a book of 10 in the Bed? This is by Penny Dale, and the illustrations are so pretty. And kids really like all of the animals: zebra, teddy bear, alligator. Kids really like to look at all of them. And for the 7-year-old, it's very easy to read. It's not too complicated. The words aren't too big. And because they might be familiar with the rhyme of Ten in the Bed, they might have an even easier time reading along. And it's got nice big text and these really, really beautiful illustrations. Yeah, really beautiful. If you like this one? Yeah, this one's really, really pretty. And it might seem a little bit young for the 7-year-old, but for independent reading, or the 7-year-old could read it to the 5-year-old. But there's some good follow-along elements in the story where you can, you know, everyone could say 10 in the bed, and they all fell out, and ouch when they fall out. And it's a really fun interactive kind of book. You think you probably want to take this one? Okay, great. If you like this one, and I think that it sounds like you like the pictures a lot, I do have another one by Pennydale. This one is Wake Up, Mr. B. Wake Up, Mr. B. This is one of my personal favorites. It's so, so, so cute. The only thing I can say is I think that this one isn't in quite as good of condition as Ten in the Bed. It's a little more heavily used. Let me see. I think that someone got a hold of a marker, as sometimes happens with kids' books, and they drew little arrows in the book. So the little girl wakes up in the morning, and I don't know if you can see because the marker's a little bit hard to see, but some young soul added arrows everywhere. So it's a little bit more used than the other one. But if you like that one and you want to buy it, I would give you 10 in the Bed for maybe 50 cents. Yeah, 50 cents seems fair. Yeah, because it is marked a little bit, but you know, it gives it a little bit of charm. I actually kind of like the arrows. They're kind of sweet. And I love this dog. He is so cute. I love dogs. Your cousins have a dog? They just got a dog. Well, if they just got a dog, they would probably really, really like this book, actually, because it has, like, imaginative play with the dog, and I think it could inspire them to come up with some interesting games to play with their new dog. Yeah. Yeah. I think that would be really, really, really cool. So this is definitely probably one you want to consider. Okay, so you want both this one and 10 in the Bed then? Okay, great, that's great. So I know on the phone you mentioned that the 7-year-old, he's a little bit rambunctious, likes jokes and humor and maybe a little bit of, like, potty humor. Yeah, they usually do at that age, and it's sweet. It's funny. They really like it. So I have two potty humor books that you might like. The first one is Walter the Farting Dog. And that's the farting dog and the girl smelling the smelly fart. Yeah, a lot of little kids really, really, really like this. They think it's really funny, and it's really popular on the shelf. Kids pick it up a lot. Some parents don't really like to encourage the potty humor, but I think it's harmless, so I think it would make you very cool in the eyes of your cousins, yeah. So the plot of this is just that, you know, they get a new dog, and it does a lot of farts. That's pretty much the whole thing. There's not a lot to this book, but it's funny. It's funny, and dust jacket, and it's in probably, it's a little, just a little bent here, but it's in close to perfect condition, so you want to think about it. Yeah, you can think about it. It's a little offbeat, but I think they might like it. The other one is a more classic, it's Where's the Poop? Yeah, it is similar to the Everyone Poops, which is a really classic. We don't have a copy of that right now. No, sorry. I could, let me think. I could order it in for you. When are you leaving to go visit your cousins? On Thursday. Okay. I could probably get it in for you by Thursday morning, but it might be a little bit close. Do you want to try? You want to try? Okay. I'll make a note of that, and then I'll do my best. I'll see what I can do to get that in for you. Yeah. I think it's starting to storm outside. I don't know. Did you hear thunder? I thought I heard some thunder. I don't know. We'll see if it comes back. So anyway, this is Where's the Poop? It's still really, really cute. And it has a lot of animals, as you can probably tell. I really like animals. And, any books that have animals. And this one has, mommy and baby animals, which is, baby animals are, of course, the only thing better than animals are baby animals. They're really, really sweet. I forgot to mention that it's a lift the flap book, so you actually look for the poop. This one is a little sticky. Let's see, how do we do it? There we go. There's the poop. So it's really cute. The interactive element with the little flaps is a lot of fun. I think everybody likes the little flap books. I think they'll tell you they're for maybe kindergarten age or first grade, but I think that even grown-ups like to lift the flaps. Yeah, I think everybody likes them. Oops. Kangaroos. And there's the poop. It's little baby kangaroo. It's really, really cute. Yeah. You want to go ahead and get this one? Okay, great. I'll put it aside for you. And then if Everyone Poops comes in, then you could package them together in the same bundle or the same wrapping paper. Yeah, I think that would be really good. Great, so I'll put it over here with the two Pennydale books that you liked. Yeah. Okay. So, my next suggestion is a little bit older. The really classic, I would say. And that's Frog and Toad. And I have Frog and Toad together. And then I have Days with Frog and Toad. Both were really, really popular. They've both been around for a while. They're by Arnold Lobel. I don't know if you know anything. You don't know anything about Frog and Toad. Okay, so unlike a lot of picture books where there's just one story in the whole book, Frog and Toad has several stories per book. So, for example, you have a little contents page here, and this book includes Tomorrow, The Kite, Shivers, The Hat, and Alone. And each story is just a few pages long, so It's very accessible, especially for like the 7-year-old. Might pick up one by themselves. Yeah, might read it alone, and it's very accessibly laid out, and the pictures help. There's frequent pictures, and that helps to reinforce the points on the text. So actually, that's really good for reading comprehension and independent reading. Yeah, because when they can look at the pictures, they can draw the connections better. In case they can't sound out a word, or they don't know what a word means, perhaps the pictures help to help them to guess or to learn. So it's really good for reading comprehension. So that's Days with Frog and Toad. And then the other one, Frog and Toad Together, has different stories. It has A List, The Garden, Cookies, Dragons and Giants, and The Dream. So again, it's the same format with the short stories, lots of pictures to help illustrate. Yeah, it is a very, I guess you might say monochromatic style. That's all shades of green. So it's maybe a little unusual by modern standards, because modern kids probably, they're used to a little bit wilder color palettes, brighter colors, and this is really earthy and subdued, and yeah, kind of reminds you of like an early autumn day with the leaves starting to change, and the fabric on their clothes is very cozy. It has a very warm, very cozy feel. Yeah, but it is, I know what you mean. It is a little bit old-fashioned. You think that maybe it's a little bit too old-fashioned. Yeah, if they're reluctant readers, reluctant just means that they're not necessarily going to choose to read, or they might need a little bit extra push to read. If that's the case, then yeah, I would say maybe this is a little bit, I don't want to say boring, because I don't think that they're boring, but a little bit subdued, maybe a little bit too neutral, I don't know. So yeah, maybe these aren't as exciting, so maybe they're not like the best choice then. Okay, yeah, no, that's totally fine. If you ever want to come back and shop for anyone else, I can always pull them out. I can tell that you like them yourself. Yeah, so maybe someone else would be... Oh, there's a little bit of damage on this book too, so I could give you a discount. If you ever come back and you want to buy it from someone, the little binding is peeling off a little bit, so... so I could give you a discount. So anyways, I'll put them aside, but I can tell that you like them, so if you ever want to come back and get them for someone else, Frog and Toad is what they're called, by Arnold Lobel. Alright. So now I have two bigger books. They're basically treasuries, where there's a lot of stories. Unlike the Frog and Toad books, these are longer stories that are just compiled into big treasuries. The first is a personal favorite of mine. I know I said that a few times, but this is a big favorite of mine, and that's Eloise. This is the ultimate collection of Eloise, and it's all of the Eloise that exists, but I can say that after they released this treasury, they released a previous unpublished manuscript. It was published posthumously, so the author was deceased, so they found this manuscript. It's called Eloise Takes a Bath. So there is a fifth one now, but when this came out there were only four. and the fifth one wasn't unfinished, or maybe not unfinished, maybe just not released, I'm not sure, but these are the four that were released in the lifetime of the author. Yeah, so still a really good collection. You could always buy, if you like these, you could always come back and buy Eloise Takes a Bath. I don't have a copy of it right now, but I would say if you want to try this book, try it, and if you decide that you want Eloise Takes a Bath, I will order it for you, and then you can come pick it up, okay? But maybe for another time, because I couldn't get it by Thursday. I think I would have to order a new copy, so yeah, it's, there's not a lot of used copies of it around, I don't think, but anyway, this is still a really great collection without Eloise Takes a Bath, and to my knowledge, there isn't a collection that includes that story yet, so Eloise is a very spunky character. She's very cute, and you can see her right there. She's very rambunctious and really funny. There's a lot of jokes. There's a lot of visual jokes as well as text jokes, where there's just some really cute, funny antics in the illustrations. Yeah, it's really, really cute. This book is maybe, all of the Eloise books are maybe a little bit heavier in text than you would expect for the ordinary picture book. Normally, picture books are very low in text or have just very short sentences and a few sentences per page. The Eloise books have a lot more, so there's a lot more text. I'll show you an example. Some pages are more expected levels of text, but then you can see here, this is quite a bit of text for a children's book. So I would say, ideally, this would be, got my fingers stuck, this would be more of a bedtime story, something that you would want an adult to read, probably. I think this would be quite challenging to read independently, maybe by 8 or 9, which is a bit old for picture books, but I would say Eloise has some appeal even when you're older. Honestly, it's funny, even if you're an adult, they're really funny. They might be more funny when you're an adult. But I would say this is not one I would expect to see kids reading independently. It's more, I would say, for a bedtime story. Yeah, but I think that it has things for everyone, for all ages, so I think it would be good for both. So I don't think that there is a contents page as such, but it does come with the absolutely essential Eloise, and Eloise in Paris, and Eloise at Christmas Time, which is one of my favorites to read. Really, I read it every Christmas, even though I just read it to myself because I like it. But yeah, it's very sweet. And then Eloise in Moscow. Yeah. Eloise in Moscow, I think, is the hardest to, the hardest reading level. And it's still my least favorite. but I think that, it's worth it as part of the complete collection. This also includes, possibly your cousin's parents might have read Eloise when they were young. It's been around for a really long time. And this comes with the absolutely essential Eloise scrapbook with some rather interesting new material and colorful comments by me, Eloise. So this is actually historical information about the creation of Eloise, and the illustrations and the writing. And so the parents might find that interesting because they might have read it. I know you don't know Eloise. Okay. But yes, so these books have been around for quite a while, and yeah, this is the Good Housekeeping clothing line of Eloise from 1958. Yeah. You can see that right there. Yeah. So this has been around for quite a while. So you might find that the parents know about it. They might be interested in reading this historical information. And there's some really interesting old pictures. And yeah, so it's just right in the middle of the book. And then goes back to the stories for the kids. So yeah, so I think this is something for all ages. If they do like Eloise... there are two Eloise movies. One is based on the absolutely essential Eloise, and it is called Eloise at the Plaza. And then there's also Eloise at Christmas Time. Two movies. Live action, yeah. Yeah, they're not animated, they're live action. And actually they have Julie Andrews, yeah. And the little girl who plays Eloise, she's... she was in a few things, and she was in the old show Medium, if you ever watched that. I can't think of her name, but she was in the daughter, I guess the oldest daughter, on the show Medium. And she looks, perfect. Just absolutely perfect for the part. The movies are great. So I highly recommend if you like these that you check out the movies. Yeah. Okay. You think you want to take it? Oh, I'm so happy. I'm really happy for you. I think you'll really like this, or if you read them to your cousins, but your cousins will really like this. I know, the point is the cousins, but I think you'll really like it. Okay, great. I'm really glad you're taking that. Okay, great. So, now the last one that I have is another treasury. Oh, sorry. I still think there's thunder outside, but I don't know. I don't know if you can hear that, but I think that it's thundering. Anyway, I hope that you don't get stuck in the rain. Anyway, here's a big treasury of fairy tales. Yeah, and this is great. I think little kids love this because it has gold pages. Yeah, look at those. They're so shiny. They can actually see my hand reflected in them. And, kids think that this is so fancy. Yes, they think that it's so fancy to have those gold pages. So, yeah, I think, it's a great choice for that reason. I can say to me personally, this is not, my favorite illustration style. I'll show you. I think, it's a little... To me, it's a little cartoony. Yeah. Which is fine. But I think, maybe... Let's see. A little cartoony. I think maybe it looks a little dated. The gold pages are really the selling point. And, it's a really nice book in terms of the amount of stories. It was made in 1994, and that's where I was saying it can look a little dated, yeah, in terms of the illustrations, but there are so many beautiful stories in this book. Beauty and the Beast, Rapunzel, Aladdin, The Sleeping Beauty, Cinderella, The Princess and the Pea, Snow White, The Steadfast Tin Soldier, which maybe is a little bit of a less popular one, Thumbelina, The Frog Prince, Pinocchio, The Emperor's New Clothes, The Little Mermaid, The Jungle Book, The 12 Dancing Princesses, Peter Pan, Robin Hood, and The Velveteen Rabbit. Yeah, so that's a lot of stories in this little book. I don't know if you can see, but whoever owned this book before, they put little check marks on the stories that they had read. Probably they wanted to try to read all of them, and they put these little checks. It's so cute. So like I said, we'll take books at any level of used. It's sad for books to ever be abandoned or forgotten completely, so it's nice, even if it's not in perfect condition, or even in, you know, barely passable condition for some of our books, not all of them. It's nice to still be able to rehome them, and it doesn't cost us anything. We have a very big facility, very, very big, so we have lots and lots and lots and lots of books. And because we have so much room, there's no reason not to keep a book, even if we're only going to sell it for 20 cents or whatever. It's still completely fine. But here you can see again the illustrations in this book. I think they leave a little bit to be desired. They're not the best, but it's still sweet because there are so many. So there's a lot of time that you can take with this book, and you can read it many, many times for bedtime stories, and you don't even have to repeat the same story, so it's really nice. Okay, you think you want to pass on this one? Yeah, that's true. I think this book maybe is a little bit older, maybe a little bit more appealing to 9, 10. Maybe 8, but I think 5 and 7, you're right, it's a little young. It is still good for bedtime stories, but yeah, I think it's probably a little young. Okay, so we're gonna put this one aside. Okay. Alright, so let's review the books that you're gonna get. And if you change your mind at all, that's not a problem. So, we have the Eloise collection. I'm really glad that you're gonna get this. You're happy too? Okay, great. Well, this one is bigger, but it does have a little bit of damage here. It doesn't have much internal damage, so it's not so bad. This originally retailed for $35, which was a little pricey. Since it has a little bit of damage, but it was a little expensive to begin with, I can give it to you for $4. Yeah. You think that's good? You think that's a great price? Oh, thank you. Yeah, we try to keep our prices as low as we can. You know, we want everyone to be able to have books. And okay, great. I'll put this over here. So that's $4. Alright, great. And then we have Where's the Poop? And Where's the Poop is going to be just $1.50. Yeah. So that puts you at just $5.50 so far. Yeah. And if the other book, Everyone Poops, comes in for you, that one's actually going to be $3 because it's a special order. Is that okay? That's okay. Alright. I thought it would be. It's not exactly breaking the bank. Okay, so we're at $5.50. for that. And now we have the last two that you chose are the two Pennydale books. We have Tin in the Bed. It does have a little bit of wearing here on the corners. I think that, let's check, but I don't think that the marker fiend got to this one. I think only the other one, so let's check and see. Yeah, I don't see any marks. No, I don't think that. Oh, there's a little tear here. Okay, so I'm gonna say that this one is $1. $1 is okay? Okay. So then we have $4, $1.50, and $1. So we're at $6.50. And then I think I told you I was just gonna throw in Wake Up Mr. B for 25 cents because of the Marker Fiend. Yeah. So I do believe there's quite a bit of markers. Yeah, so the inside cover, I think, got the worst of it. I think they were drawing connections between all of these little items in here. And so I got the worst of it, but it's still very readable, and I think this is the worst, I think this is the most graffitied on picture with these arrows, so it's not too bad. You still want it? Okay, great. So that's 25 cents. So that brings your total to $6.75. Alright. There you go. Thank you. And, make sure you don't get caught in the rain. I do think that it is raining now. I think we really did hear some thunder. So, have a good day. Don't get stuck in the rain. And I really hope that your cousins are happy with these books. Okay. Well, come back soon, and I'd be happy to help you again. You can always call ahead, and I'll put books aside for you. Okay. Bye-bye.